Hello friends, I am Gaurav Murghare from Department of Electronics and Communication, Oriental Institute of Science and Technology, Bhopal. As from the previous lectures, today I am going to present a video lecture on the inverse Z transform topic. As you all know that we use the Z transform technique to convert any time domain, especially the discrete time domain signal, into the Z domain. For that, the various formula and the some transformation pairs and the properties we have discussed in our last lecture. Now today we are converting the inverse Z transform. That means if the signal is already represented in the Z domain, then we will convert that signal into the time domain by using the mathematical tool, which is the inverse Z transform. It is just the simple. If you all see, the representation for the signal is very easy. If x is known to us, we'll calculate the inverse Z transform for that and we will get the signal xn. X is the representation of signal in frequency domain or the Z domain, as from the first lecture, and xn is the signal in time domain. This can be also represented by the equation in the integral format. Here the 1 upon 2 pi is the time period and integration is the closed path integration for the signal x set for the limit of or undergoes the z. There are methods to calculate the inverse z transform, but normally we will use the 3 to 4 methods. The first method, if we'll see, is the long division method. Second is the partial fraction expansion method, and third is the residual or the contour integration method. Most of the time we use the partial fraction expansion method to calculate the inverse Z transform. First, we'll start with the long division method. Long division method, in the long division method, we'll be having the signal or the Z domain representation of any signal in the form of n by d. That means this is the numerator term and this is the denominator term. These numerator and denominator term can be made in the form of polynomial or any linear expression in terms of Z. What will be will calculate this by the long division technique. I am writing here, the long division technique is the simplest technique. We all know that. What we will do, we will put the numerator term and the denominator term as the divisor, and now we will calculate this term. So whatever the terms coming out as the quotient will be in the form of this equation. This equation either can be form of z to the power minus term or can be in the form of z to the power plus term. You are clearly seeing that here the term is z to the power minus 1, or maybe for some cases your power will be in the form of z to the power, z will go in the positive power, and in some cases it will go in the negative power, and so on. It's just a simple clear representation that if the signal is greater than 0, that means right hand side sequence, then you will always going to get the power of z as the negative. And whenever the signal is in left hand side or lesser than value, the value of samples is lesser than 0, that means negative samples, then the power of z is the positive. Next method, the most common method, is the partial fraction expansion method. In the partial fraction expansion method, the term numerator upon denominator can be break into the partial fractions so that we can easily correlate with the required or the known Z transform terms or transform pairs. From that we can easily calculate it. But If the ratio is not proper or it is improper, then we have to convert it into proper form to solve the partial fraction expansion method. Third, residual method. In the residual method, we will calculate the residue by calculating the poles of whatever the terms given in the XZ or the question. Now, after substituting those values of poles in terms of Z by calculating the differentiation term, and lastly, if we'll substitute the limits for that term, then we will get the values residues, and we'll substitute these values and form our equation or the known signal. Now we will go for a numerical to test these things. In the given question, it is clearly mentioned that a term s n plus 1 minus 3 s n plus 1 plus 2 s n is equal to 10, and it is mentioned that initial conditions are 0 for the question. Normally this question can be maybe in the form of f, maybe in a form of x, or maybe in a form of s. So no need to worry about that. S is just the representation, it is just showing a function. So what we will do, we will convert this equation by converting the Z transform of that given equation or the system response. We know that the S of n having the Z transform of SZ, S of n plus 1 is having the Z transform of Z to the power plus 1 into S of Z, and similarly S of n plus 2 having the Z transform of Z square into S of Z. We already know that we have used this property of time shifting in this term. Now we'll arrange this equation taking the S of Z as common. So our equation is coming out to be Z square minus 3Z plus 2 is equal to 1. Now what we have did, we have calculated the poles, and after that we have done the partial fraction these for the terms. So the roots are Z minus 2 and Z minus 1 for this particular equation, and after solving the partial fraction we got the alpha 1 and alpha 2 coefficient as the 1 and 1, and we know that 1 upon Z minus 2 minus 1 upon Z minus 1 is having the inverse Z transform of 2n minus 1 minus of 1 to the power n minus 1. If you know that 1 to the power n minus 1 is always the minus 1, so we have represented this term in the form of that. So this is our solution, and we can multiply a u and with this term. Second example. In the second example, here we have given a difference equation. In the difference equation, what we have done? We have calculated simply. Again, the question is given in the form of yn. First, we will calculate the z transform for that term. So z transform for this term is mentioned here. This is the z transform. Now we will calculate the ratio of yz upon xz. Yz upon xz is calculated out to be 2 upon 1 minus 1 by 2 z inverse. We know that a to the power n un is having the z transform of 1 upon 1 minus az inverse. So for this term we will get the value of a as 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 to the power n un, and 2 is multiplied with that. So this is the answer for our this example. Third example. It is again here the initial condition are not 0. The initial condition is having the value of 1. So again for this third question we have calculated the z transform and substitute the value of initial condition y of minus 1 and y of minus 2 as 1. So we have got the equation of 1 minus 2z upon 4z. In this question it is mentioned that we have to calculate the term yz. So we have calculated the term yz. And if someone asks to calculate the value of yn or response for that, then we can use any of the method which we have discussed to calculate the yn or inverse z transform for that. So friends, I hope you have understood this.